We got it. The meatball pickup. This is not as uncommon as it once used to be, but every time I see this hero, I love it because he's exciting. Like, Poof just does a ton of damage. Like, he'll just destroy you with a Blink Poof combo if you do get that Blink Deck early on. And with this lineup, I'll relocate with Meepo or with the Sven, and then Meepo bots in, or I don't know. And plus, you have like Ogre Magi to lock heroes down, Puck to keep them all together to get poofed on. This could be a disgusting combo coming out for Team Tinker. Power Rangers, we haven't talked a lot about their draft. They have Chikiro, they have Pushing Power with the Liquid Fire, which we don't see too often anymore. And then the Crystal Man. This choice.
That does not seem like a hero you want against Ogre, Sven, and Meepo.
No, it really doesn't.
Or Puck.
Maybe you're like, okay, well, we're just going to use our ultimate. We're going to use the Crystal Maiden Freezing Field and just try to kill Meepo as quickly as possible. But even that seems like there's really no point in that.
I mean, I guess they needed some sort of serious magic damage to threaten Meepo, you know?
Yes.
Because with Warcry, physical damage is not going to do it.
No.
So, yeah, this is kind of an interesting choice. Man. I mean, yeah, there are other options. I think Lina.
Lich.
Maybe a consideration. Lich consideration. Crystal Maiden is just so squishy.
Witch Doctor.
You know, the thing about Crystal Maiden, I mean, maybe she's good in this meta. We haven't really seen her in this meta, but
she
asks a lot of, like, the map. You know, she needs levels. She needs some farm to get some items. Otherwise, she is slow, immobile, paper thin. Like, she just asks a lot more than a lot of supports.
Like, you need to have successful ganks with her. Otherwise, she's just useless. That's just how it goes. And you know, I'm very surprised that they picked this hero. I think they picked it yesterday, and it really didn't go well either. And I really thought that hero was just an awful choice for them. But maybe they're trying to prove something here, and I hope that they can get it done. Because right now, they're sitting down 0-1 against Team Tinker, a team that is very solid, and they've gotten quite the draft for themselves. And so, for the rating team for Power Rangers, down 0-1 like I was just discussing. Well, if Cheshire Cat playing your offlane Faceless Void, mid lane it is going to be Shaquille playing your Death Prophet. Joining him currently will be J4, not sure for what reason. Down bottom, we have Weejasick playing your support Nagasaur, and then Nexus, your core Chikiro. And this draft is interesting as all hell, so.
Yeah, I mean, core Chikiro, we've seen the power of that. You level up the Liquid Fire, you can push down towers extremely easily. I really like Team Tinker's draft. It's got a lot of stuff going on for it. It deals with a lot of the problems that Power Rangers are presenting with the Death Prophet, with the Faceless Void. The Naga is not going to be that big of a factor this game as in terms of farming, obviously, as this looks to be a support Naga. So, I'm not sure. What do you think about support Naga?
I think it has its place. It's really good in transitioning. The thing is like, if you have enough room to transition later on in the game, it could work out really well. Double damage, Weejasick steals it right out from underneath EGM, and he actually takes two big hits and then has to tether away, so that could have been huge for EGM, but Weejasick gets it anyways. I think Nagasaurus' support works fine, as long as you can get kills and be able to pull, stack some camps, and even just transition later on into maybe getting treads and like a Manta or like a Diffusal Blade or what have you.
You know, from first glance, I have to say, I think if Power Rangers don't somehow win their lanes or don't have like perfect chronos, they're just gonna get rolled in the mid game.
Yeah.
Like Meepo is gonna be a huge problem for them. They don't really have any good answer to that, honestly. I mean, maybe you catch one in chrono and then you can kill him. But then the other problem is there's Pycat on Sven with this Wisp. Bulba's got some really good CCs. And then of course you have Puck, so I think this draft has a lot of intricacies going on for Tinker and a lot of problems that Power Rangers, I'm just not sure they can deal with. So
yeah, I really feel like it's going to come down.
I mean,
this is when
the Naga support, I think, is really not good, because Naga is another support that asks a lot in terms of, you know, needing level 6 to be able to have that control in the fights.
Well, here's the thing. She has armor reduction coming up from Riptide.
Yeah,
I mean, that's a little thing coming up for Weejasick, but at least it's something that they have. And it's maybe not as bad as people anticipate, but again, it comes down to the laning phase. And currently, Shaklo is having a good time. This is against the illustrious Sing Sing Meepo. And he's very close to divided. We stand level 1. Poof, get 1 CS, get level 3, get his clone now. Boom, he's good to go. So.
Yeah, Meepo mid lane. Death Prophet can't really do that much against him as long as Sing Sing is very careful with the way he micros his illusions. Obviously, very easy for him to get decent rune control with Meepo, so this is kind of interesting. Cheshire Cat's taking some damage in the top lane. The Stormhammer was already used, so no risk there. Bulba's still level 1, hasn't skilled yet, and they stacked there.
Fire Blast, I imagine. Meanwhile, Invis rune picked up for Sing Sing. And Bouncy Rune picked up 4, we just 6, so he does not get that nice and biz rune. Meanwhile, Bulba and EGM tether together. They're chasing down Cheshire Cat, but he's just going to walk up to the high ground. He'll be fine. No early kill this time around, so just 2 minutes in, and a lot of just heroes farming. Puck is okay. Koifu's sitting at right now level 2, trying to avoid a lot of that damage from Nexus. Phase shifts one of it, and then he's just going to take the Liquid Fire, so
that's so annoying.
The worst of the trade there.
Yeah, that's pretty frustrating, but I mean, in terms of dying, it seems like it should be pretty hard for Koifu to die here. Even like, look at the pressure coming out right now. He's just got a lot of options. As long as he orbs before he phase shifts, if they're both the heroes are there, he should be fine, because he just needs to make sure he, you know, phases the net and then jaunts away from the ice path when that gets leveled up. So
it's not as easy as you'd think.
But it's not as easy as you'd think, but Koifu, I have faith.
He's fine, yeah.
Oh, God.
Phase shifts the tick of that fire.
That's so annoying.
This is a squishy hero and taking. Oh, God. Well, that's Sing Sing getting caught out. They had J4 rotating through. I actually saw it happen, but the Crystal Nova comes out, the Frostbite as well, and Shacklow gets his first blood. They shut him down. Meanwhile, top lane, Cheshire Cat has to time walk away from any sort of harassment coming out from Team Tinker, so.
Yeah, and that's a little annoying. But this is sort of the issue with Crystal Maiden is she can just farm the jungle with Frostbite. So looks like Crystal Maiden's gonna get the space that we were talking about, gonna get the farm we were talking about. Already almost level 4, pretty impressive. And oh man, this bottom lane is just annoying for Koikova because of the Liquid Fire. He's taking a lot of damage.
Cheshire Cat gets out just in time. Bycat using a lot of his Storm Hammers just to try to get these kills and not able to do so. They're zoning him out pretty well though. He only has 4 last hits. Puck is 9, so Koikova's doing a bit better in this bottom lane in comparison to the offlaners.
Koifu are going to go for the bottom rune here, but so is the Naga, so we're going to see a little bit of a battle over this, and he actually completely whiffs on the Riptide, so that's annoying. Gets the rune.
Nicely done.
He's going to head on out of there.
Root Control now going for Team Tinker. They get both of the runes, the Illusion top, the Bouncy down to the bottom lane, and more farming going the way of both squads. PyCat sitting at the top, or at least tab with the top of 23 last hits. However, bottom lane, Jakiro. Oops.
Oh, Cheshire Cat's gonna take some damage here.
Yeah, dude.
He might even die.
Around. He's got the time walk. He's got a time walk into the trees if necessary. Fire Blast, they can't get it done. Here comes J4 and the rest of the squad. Jackal coming in. This is a big, hefty dive from Tink Tinker. Maybe something that will cause them to go down. Bulba getting low. Stormhammer coming in. Cheshire Cat falls. They block Bulba and PyCat in. Oh no, PyCat, he's gotta get out. EGM has tether in 5. PyCat getting low. EGM about to fall, and looks like Will double kill from Shacklow. PyCat in trouble as Will getting chased down. Will survive.
Okay. He has Warcry.
Yeah, he's good to go himself, so he's fine. But still, 2-for-1 trade.
That was quite the dive. And I think when Cheshire Cat went into the trees there, when they didn't get the immediate fire blast with the spirits, they should have just pieced.
So, bit unfortunate for Team Tinker, but Bulba smoked up looking for a kill. We Just Sick is going to spot him out and back up immediately, and Sing Sing is nowhere near to getting that kill. In fact, We Just Sick is looking for an ensnare. Will not be able to catch up to Bulba. Maybe he can. Well, maybe not. They're thinking about it. We Just Sick, if he throws an ensnare now, it's kind of a waste, so he'll back away. And the thing is, though, Shackle has a lot of farm. He's got 3 kills and 27 CS, so as Sing Sing is doing this lane, like, that's huge for Shacklow.
I mean, that was a huge rotation for him. He gets a bunch of kills and a lot of XP. Sing Sing, though, is level 6, and he's farming. I mean, he's doing fine. Like, this is as good as you can really want out of your Meepo. So, you have to remember, Meepo's farm rate accelerates just quite a bit as soon as he gets another Meepo. So when there's 2, he kind of has to keep them together. When there's 3, you can rotate them around. You can use them to heal in the fountain. There's a lot more playstyles sort of open up.
Oh. Well, we're going to get Crystal Nova. Exorcism is going to go as well. But was like, please, no, I don't have boots. Come on, Frostbitten. He's going to fall. He does get the Fire Blast off, but to no avail. And Bulba's actually having a really rough Ogre game now, so.
Yeah, Ogre's not great when you're very behind like this. You want the multicast, obviously, to help you win those team fights. Koikva does have a double damage rune, and he is doing just fine. The Void is actually the same level as him, so both offlaners doing pretty well.
Yeah, Cheshire Cat has less CS though, so Koikva's getting a bit more out of the map than Cheshire Cat is, but now he's starting to man up on PyCat. PyCat backing away. This tower is getting low. They want this Core Jakiro to come into effect and have them push down towers, get them some extra gold. They want to try to ball up. This is the thing. This is like a 6.81 meta, but all of a sudden, when you get level 6, especially on PyCat and EGM, then it gets very difficult for them to be able to do that. And they'll just start killing heroes like crazy. Although EGM is very far away from that. He's only level 3 currently. He's got to continue to pull and get some experience elsewhere. Bulba is stacking, it looks like, and he's still level 2. But
yeah, he's just stacking for Sing, I think. I mean, that's fine.
Yeah.
Like, the thing is that Meepo is going to break open this game, I think, pretty soon. So it doesn't take that much for Meepo to really start going nuts. As soon as you have that Blink Dagger, you have a lot of roaming potential. EGM is doing fine on levels. He's almost level 6, and it's still only 7 minutes. Pycat's level 6 as well, so maybe some Relocate ganks could be in the future. There is the Naga against the Relocate, which is very, very good. Quakefuff phases 1 Liquid Fire, eats the Dual Breath, and anytime you can phase shift a Liquid Fire, you are a happy camper.
I mean, he's like 1,400 gold already, and this is going to be an early Blink Dagger for an offlaner. This guy is just so damn good, like, at everything. You just find farm where there shouldn't be any farm at all. Glyph coming out of the Radiant side, Dire side, Illusory Orb going to come out. Fire Blast, Nexus getting caught, but no Illusory Orb damage. Waning Rift might go. There's the Stormhammer, Dream Coil as well. Nexus about to fall, and the Waning Rift going just to secure the kill. Beautifully done from Team Tanker, securing that kill without even taking any damage.
Jesus, and Sing Sing just got both the runes.
Yeah, that was actually just ridiculous. I just saw them all pop up on the side there, so.
Oh, welcome to Meepo. I mean, pretty easy to get both the runes, to be honest, so. Sinks, or,
Chrono EGM, look out, buddy. Cannot tether away. Cheshire Cat getting involved with his first kill.
Chronosphere used for that one, and that's, I mean, just to be expected. You're going to get Chrono and die, and if it's just your Whispus dying, it's not too bad. With Sing Sing continuing to farm up here, almost has the Blink Dagger, but Power Rangers, they are getting some crucial farm and experience on the Faceless Void. Naga's almost level 6 as well, so things going well in that department. Level 7 for Nexus, so he has the max Liquid Fire. Mechanism is actually done for Nexus, so they're just going to keep on pushing.
Yeah, they want to fight now, they want to fight early. But like you mentioned, I mean, you almost have your Blink Daggers up, you almost have your levels that are really important. There's the Tether, Stormhammer going to go. We just take no level 6, by the way. Ice Path might fly. Warcry. No mana for the use of the God Strength there. There's the Ensnare. Pycat getting low. And there's the Macro Pyre. Time lock in. Pycat getting caught. Oh. What a bash! Cheshire Cat! Oh, God. RNG. You've got to be kidding me.
Yeah, I'm sure there was some anger there. Pycat gets pretty salty, and that was like, a pretty unfortunate bash, to be honest.
And they're going to keep pushing the tower. No mech.
Sing is up here, though. I mean, the problem is that can you even initiate into this many heroes with Meepo at this point? Uh-oh. Maybe you have to now. EGM gets bashed again. Jesus.
Dream Coil on it too. Illusory Orb coming in. Waning Rift might fly from Quakefuff, but the mech is there. Fire Blast. Cheshire Cat taking a lot of that damage. Meepo pooping on the backside. Can't find out where. Exorcism coming in now. Quakefuff, you've got to be kidding me with these bashes. Cheshire Cat still alive, and he might make it out. Looks like he will. Warcry coming in from Pycat. He's chasing the wrong direction. Shocklow. Bulba gets blocked by the Creep Wave. Crypt Swarm coming up. Double kill for Shocklow. They broke this game wide open. Pycat really wants Cheshire Cat, but there's the Crystal Nova. Pycat cannot continue to chase.
Oh, no. Sing is going straight for Ags.
Yeah.
All right. I mean, I guess it could be a straight BKB. That seems absolutely awful. But, man,
just
this is...
Cat Song, if they want to use it. Now, they'll back away. That was an awful fight. Those bashes were unbelievable.
Yeah, I mean, he got like 4 or 5 really important bashes in that, so that's pretty ridiculous. But Sing Sing not going for the Blink Dagger here, it seems like a bit of a mistake to me. I mean,
I usually see this, though, actually. It's mostly Agam's first a lot of the time I see this hero.
That's true, I guess. I mean, I'm just thinking, like, they've just been losing all these fights, and I think they might benefit a bit from Sing. But,
you can split push, though, especially
I mean, I guess by going for the Ags first, you're more committed to the long game, so I guess that's fine if that's the way they want to bring it. They also still don't have Relocate for EGM. He's having some trouble here in the last couple of minutes. He needs to get that level 6. Maybe they can start some ganks here with the Sven. Is he actually going to get this stack?
This is a really, really, really rough game for EGM. 3 deaths, not even an urn yet. He's got boots at the very least, but
should be level 6, though.
Yeah, I mean, this is going to be level 6, and that's great, but, you know, he needs a bit more. The Yule Scepter is now already done, so even if you relocate on top of the Death Prophet, you're going to get Yules. If you relocate on top of the Naga, she'll just song, so this is kind of a tough game now for Team Tinker, although the Blink Dagger is up for Quakefa. We saw that in the last fight, but it's really not... It's not quite there yet for this squad. They do have 3 of the top 5 in net worth, but Death Prophet is by far and away in the lead. In fact, his drum is now almost done.
I mean, he's 5-0. He's 7K net worth. He is well ahead of anyone on the other side for Tinker, and this is when Death Prophet really gets out of control. When he hits level 11, he already has a Yules and almost has a drums as well. That's pretty ridiculous farm.
It absolutely is. And they're going to try to take this tier 1 tower mid, which will give them even more farm. Ice Path going through, Quickly avoids it, but they will take the tower just through positioning alone. And all the tier 1s now gone off the map for Team Tinker. They have yet to take one in their own right. So one thing about Death Prophet is that it's great for balling up, but it's even better for team fighting, especially like you talked about when you get your level 2 ultimate and especially level 3 ultimate. But here comes the squad of Power Rangers. Chronosphere going to fly onto Bulba. It looks like he will fall again. Level 4. Ogre Magi is having one rough game.
Yeah, Bulba just cannot find a place where he's not going to die. They are committing a lot to killing him, but at the same time, they're also getting tons of towers with the Jakiro. Sing Sing now going to work on the bottom tower. He's actually getting very close to the Ags, but oh no, if he dies here, this is going to be very unfortunate. They're going to turn around. Cheshire Cat eats a stun. They bring him down. Sing Sing is so close to dying, though. The Warcry keeping him alive for the moment. No, he's still going to go down in the end, but Shocklo might pay for it with his life. Oh, a beautiful song comes in. J4 has rotated as well, and if they don't get this kill on Shocklo, they're gonna be real sad, and he starts to bottle up. Piecat turns it around. Yes, he still gets the kill. He wants We Just Zik. Beautiful mechanism by Nexus. Piecat trying to make it out. No, he's gonna die as well. Team Tinker just can't get a clean fight. J4 now at risk. Quakeva darting forward, gets a nice orb off there. There's one kill. They want We Just Zik. He's stuck in the trees. He's coming out. Bulba's trying to run him down, but Bulba just can't do anything this game. Dying again. Quakeva. No, he tries to tether him. Quakeva left behind, but he does have the blink dagger. He should be okay. But now EGM is going to probably die. What a weird fight. Team Tinker, I guess they did okay there, but not a clean fight again.
They do get the better end of the golden
exchange. Yeah, they definitely get the better end of the
fight.
He
actually makes it out. They don't even go for the kill on EGM. Wow. They were scared that they were going to bring somebody in there, maybe like Sing Sing. And that's a smart play just to leave him alone. So a huge fight coming through. They still don't get the tier 1 tower, but that somehow goes okay for Team Tinker. And they bring it back about 1,000 gold, but 1,000 net worth. But still, they're kind of far away from being able to take this game cleanly. Although, Sing is about 200 gold away from his Aghanim Scepter, so there's that.
That's nice. That's important. Like, that needs to be done now, so we can buy Blink Dagger and participate in fights.
He's actually not that bad in terms of
farming. Yeah, I mean, he's actually farmed this unbelievably quickly. I mean, this is, I sort of underestimated the farming speed of Meepo, and this turns out this Axe Burst isn't really going to hurt him that much, even despite that death down bottom.
Yeah, that's fine. He'll get up Zag's Town. It's flying out to him currently, so he's got that going for him. Bulba is just desperately looking for any semblance of farm. He'll hit level 5. Level 6 is what you want to get, so you have your multicast. Otherwise, he's just a walking stun, and that's about it. A walking tanky stun. Meanwhile, Piecat pops the God Strength. They'll take this giant stack for him and give him the overcharge as well. So EGM making sure Piecat takes this safely and soundly. And only level 1 cleave. It's kind of tough, though, but he's doing a nice job of clearing this out. BKB should be done pretty soon. Although he does only have the Ogre Club and 500 gold in the bank, so he does get a lot of gold out of that at the very least.
Yeah, and they're going to start the relocate game soon. I mean, Crystal Maiden's pretty much free kill. Sing Sing taking some damage. Going to poof on out of here, no problems. Does have that Axe finished up, so now Sing Sing going to look to go to work. And, you know, I'm not sure why I doubted Sing Sing. He's definitely one of the masters of Meepo.
He certainly is. He's up there, I think, with some of the top Meepos in the game. And he's having a great time currently. Again, this is where I think Power Rangers need to keep the pressure on. They're not really doing so. They're just maybe thinking, well, hold that thought. Stormhammer is going to connect on Cheshire Cat, but way too far away for them to get the kill, so he just time walks away. But yeah, I think Power Rangers, either you go for Roche, you go for another tower. You have level 2 ultimate coming up from Death Prophet. You have the Ulysses, like we're talking about. You have the mech. There is no reason to not take an objective here, and they're doing just that. And they'll probably give Shocklo here in Aegis.
Maybe this gives some PR a little bit of a kick in the butt here to start moving forward on these tier 2 towers, which are all still alive. Quakeva, though, tossing the orb in the pit. Unfortunately, he's a little early on that one. And are they going to try to steal this? Seems pretty unlikely.
Naga Siren is around, I think.
Yeah, I think going on this with a Naga in the vicinity is a big mistake.
They're
going
to give the Roche up. Shacklo will pick up the Aegis, and that orb came out a bit too late. Although the tier 1 tower does fall to Sing Sing, and now he's starting to really participate. Chronosphere, Quakeva getting caught at. Bulba is going to stun up on Cheshire Cat. He gets the relocate coming in. Piecat's about to fly. There's the song, though, but they will grab the kill on Cheshire Cat. This fight, they don't have the exorcism. Macropire, Ice Path coming in. Freezing Field. What a combo. Sing Sing poofs in, though. Stormhammer coming in. Piecat, God Strength. What can they get done? Sing Sing has to back away with that one Meepo getting so low. He's body blocking himself. No, Sing falls. All 5 dead. Team Tinker get obliterated. What a fight for Power Rangers. Unbelievable.
What a song. What an Ice Path. Four heroes stuck together. Jesus.
That was BKB's boys.
Oh man, that was really bad. Quagba manning up here. They're gonna buy back on the Sven as well. They put him up in the air. This is gonna make it a little bit harder. Silence blinks, and are they gonna actually be able to start something here? I don't think so. Man, that was really bad. Disaster, man. That was an amazing song, though. Holy crap.
That song, they don't save Cheshire Cat, but he's perfectly okay with them killing all five heroes.
What happened after that, he's like, all right, team, good job. Thanks.
I'm just going to lounge back in the base for a second. Yeah, he's feeling pretty confident now. I mean, that fight gives them, it's actually not that big of a net worth lead, but it's certainly starting to build that way. 5,000 net worth advantage. The Naga goes for a Vanguard, which I imagine has to be built into a Crimson Guard at some point in time. Because this item's just awful alone. Although, I guess on a support Naga, maybe not as bad. 4,000 experience lead now coming out for Power Rangers. Top lane, Cheshire Cat, Blink, Quakefa. Gets time locked. Fire Blast, Multicast coming in. Poof. And they will grab Cheshire Cat, so.
Hold on, have we glossed over the fact here that Quakefa has a Midas?
I noticed it, but I didn't mention it.
What?
That was about 5 minutes ago, I'd say. Maybe a little bit less. Yeah. Yep. I think EGM's actually dead. Meanwhile, Pika does get the tier 1 tower. EGM about to fall. And, well, so Nexus gets a dominating spree for himself. And meanwhile, they're trying to pressure this top tier 1 tower. All of a sudden, despite Team Taker going down and losing all five heroes, they're in a position where they're starting to take towers now. Shockwave just throws up Quake from the air. Phase shift, and he's actually just dead. He TP'd right here when Shockwave just walks in, and I don't know what that was about.
This looks like a completely different Team Tinker than last game. I don't really know what's going on here. Same thing seems like the only glue that's like keeping this team together, honestly. Like
this Ogre pick has not paid off for Bulba.
Yeah, I mean, Bulba is just getting absolutely destroyed. Pycat, we haven't really seen one aggressive relocate. We haven't even seen one to really save, so.
I mean, they relocated to a Song of the Sire, and you're gonna die, or you're going to get caught out, or you're going to have a bad time. That's exactly what happened. Exorcism of the top tier 2 tower. Heart's almost done for Shocklo. Level 2 Exorcism. They can't even defend this. There is the BKB now done for Pycat, but they're just going to give that tier 2 tower away. They only have one left to go. Sing's getting roomed, yes, and his blink should be done if he wants to build it up, which I think he's going to buy now. And there it is. But you've got to get something done here.
I mean, I think the good news here is that this game gets better for Tinker in the next 10 minutes.
Yes, well, like, absolutely.
I mean, Death Prophet is still a huge issue, but now Sven has a BKB plus Warcry. He's going to be pretty difficult to kill. Sing Sing has a Blink Dagger, so now he can help initiate. Koikva's got a Midas, which is goddamn, dude. No comment about that one.
I mean, he just wants to farm, man.
I mean, I guess Tinker are committed to the long game if they're buying a Hand of Midas on their puck after Blink Dagger.
Yes.
So they know that in the short term, they lose to Death Prophet. In the long term, we know once they have Warcry plus AC up, that Death Prophet's going to do jack. It's not really going to be doing anything at all, to be honest.
Well, there's still a long way away before Team Tinker can get really involved in these engagements. And Power Rangers are playing and controlling this map pretty effectively, I'm going to be honest. They're pushing when they need to push. They're fighting when they need to
fight. Yeah, I mean, it looks bad for them, but they're controlling the game and they're keeping the farm under control. Most of that is coming up to Sing Sing, honestly. I mean, Death Prophet really is the only one out of hand. Death Prophet does have a heart now, though, and that's an item you have to be a little bit afraid of. But God Strength plus Meepo, I mean, I think you should be able to bring her down.
Seer's actually just so dumb.
That's a lot of HP, 2,400.
It wouldn't bother me so much if she wasn't a fucking race car, but she is. So she just moves extraordinary. It's just so dumb how fast she can move with Witchcraft and Phase and Drum and Yules. It's just like, vroom, vroom, you can't catch me. I'm going to kill everybody because I hit my R button. It's like, why? That's so dumb. I'm not a big fan of Seer, but Shackle's playing it really well.
Pycat needs assistance in the mid lane.
Oh, we missed the silence. BKB, time to TP out, everybody.
Alright.
No one's staying left. Smart play.
Yeah, I mean, not how you want to use your 10-second BKB charge, but sometimes
worst
you gotta do.
Worst things can happen. Like, your entire 5
Naga's going for a
dying.
Crimson Guard.
Yeah, I talked about that already.
Nifty. Alright.
So oh, that's a Chronosphere. Sing Sing is gonna get caught out and looks like he will fall.
Can I actually
like
kill him, though?
This is tough. I mean, they're doing a lot of damage here. Ice Path's gonna go and Sing will fall, so.
Shockwave's stealing that deal.
Kill secured.
Yeah. Continuing forward here, Sing Sing just needs to just keep farming. Like, he just needs to get more farm, more items. You know, if he goes for Scotty or something like that. Sing always plays the Scotty heroes, it seems like. But
yeah, he really does. And the thing is, though, I usually like seeing Meepo when you're snowballing out of control and you're able to just poof and kill every hero on the map. But he's actually behind in this game, so now you have to wonder how effective is he going to be, you know, come... I think he'll still be
very good just because they have the toolkit with Sven.
Yes.
Assuming that Pycat goes for an AC here in the near future, and I'm not sure there's a world where he doesn't, to be honest.
Armor reduction and buffing your own armor. I mean, in this game,
it's so good. Against Death Prophet, it's going to be really, really nice. Their tier 3 is taking damage, though, and I'm not really sure what Pycat and EGM are trying to get done here. I mean, it doesn't seem like they're going to get the tier 2.
They're finally going to TP Pycat back. They'll throw out the Stormhammer. They're going to blink in, Sing Sing poops out as well, but there's the Song. They're trying to burst him down with the Song going. He's got to back away and snare now. Here we go. Song's done. They're still chasing. We just say, but look at the damage. Freezing Field coming out. J4, beautifully done. Pycat throws up the multicast. That's actually Bulba getting the kill there. Now Time Walk in. Chronosphere not up for another 10, but Quagga getting blown up. This might be it for Team Tinker. Sing Sing forced to buy back. Yule Scepter up in the air on 2. Everybody Cyclone, it's a tornado party. Chronosphere coming in.
Oh, God.
This is not looking good. If Sing Sing dies here, this might be game. He's very low. He will fall to Cheshire Cat. Double kill for Nexus. Ice Path coming in. Time Walk further. Pycat getting blown up as well as EGM. They're getting overrun. Quickfoot back in. Waiting Rift. Nexus getting chased down. Meanwhile, there's the Fire Blast. Nexus. Mech-up still alive somehow. Backs away, but Ice Path not connecting. Yule Scepter keeps him up. 2 dead now for Power Rangers. They're starting to turn this around. They do get the Radiant Courier. Bulba falls in the end. Quagga. The double kill for Shocklow, the Crypt Swarm. And they're backing away now. They've taken not the Tier 3 tower, but a huge fight. Pycat avoids the Ice Path. Nexus will. Oh! What a Yule Scepter, but Nexus should still fall. Maybe EGM stunned in place, locked up at the Ice Path, I believe. They can't bring him down. They're kiting them so effectively. Pycat about to fall and will. 5 dead. They turn it around after running a marathon all the way back from the base. My God.
Tinker is just rolled on in these fights.
Look at the fight recap, man. That's rough.
Oh my God. That XP change is real. I mean, tons of buybacks there. That was a messy fight for Tinker. And, you know, that fight was just a result of the earlier game symptoms, which are supports that are doing nothing. Sing Sing, that's a little bit behind. And now we'll see if they can actually kill Choclo here. They're going to try. And there's a nice silence that's getting all of them. He is going to fall in the end. Pycat comes in. BKB's up. They want to bring down Ouija Zig. The Rexler are still alive, so maybe this game's not over for Team Tinker. Another kill for Sing Sing. That's 3 for him. And Team Tinker... They're not going out of this without fighting, and then their racks are still alive, so maybe they're okay. I mean, that was a huge fight that they lost, but they at least get something out of that
pretty much nullifies the change in golden and experience from that last engagement, surprisingly enough.
I mean, they killed Shocklo, and he had an unstoppable streak plus the comeback gold. I mean, Shocklo is 13-2, so that's pretty insane.
I think that was a huge mistake for Power Rangers. They don't have all their ultimates. There's no reason for them to fight there. And now they give room to a lot of these heroes. Blackhead starts taking some of these inches. Again, you talked about they haven't lost their axe yet. This game's still definitely in the wings right now. We don't know who could come out on top.
Yeah, pretty unfortunate that Roshan wasn't up there. This is a very long duration Roshan. If Roshan had been up, then I think Tinker would have actually just been in a fine position. And it is going to be the AC next for Pycat. No surprises there that minus armor on the other team and plus armor for his team is going to be extremely valuable. Meepo going to do a little bit of extra damage as well due to that. And I really like the AC this game. I mean, we've talked about it a bunch already, but it seems like a great pickup.
Bulba need to pick it up this game.
Has 1,200 gold. He just needs to figure out a way to stop dying, whether that's like a force staff or even if you get like a drum or something. I don't know.
Just buy a force staff, Bulba. I think that's exactly what he's going to do. I mean, he loves that item. I think Quick is dead. Face shifts the silence, but well, he's actually just dead. Time lock. I thought he was going to get time lock for sure.
One time. Cheshire Cat's probably like, all right, well, I mean, I guess my RNG button broke. Yeah. I'll be fine for the next game, guys.
I was pretty lucky for the first 40 minutes or 25 minutes of this game, but Sing Sing might get caught up. They have Frodo. Stormhammer going in, though. Sing Sing, he won't take all this damage. Cheshire relocating it as well. Cheshire Cat's going to fall. What a turnaround. Relocated, but there's the song. We just sick. What is he doing here?
Is he going to do anything?
They're going to relocate out. Sing Sing might actually live.
Are they?
Still. Yep. Yep. Look at the relocate out from Sing Sing, or blink out Sing Sing, I mean, relocate
thought,
out from
Honestly, Reno. I thought they might have tried to turn that fight around. It was I guess they don't know where Shocklo is, so it's a little bit too
really
much of a risk.
Play, I think. Also, the song is now down. There's no reason.
Yeah, song down, and I think if Shocklo shows up at that fight, they have a lot of issues.
Sounds up.
With him there, with him not there, it's okay. And
this is the biggest issue, is somehow killing this Death Prophet in this
if
game.
If Team Tinker can get this Roshan, I think they're in good shape. I mean, they're still in trouble, but that gold graph, look at the XP graph, oh my god. Just 6.82 things.
Yeah, I mean, we talk about the bounties being changed, but this is still pretty ridiculous. Tether up, Ice Path, Pycat, he's got to BKB, he's very low macro power, they need to leave now. Crimson Guard is up. That's a Stormhammer on an illusion. Time to get out, boys. Yeah, definitely time to leave.
Wasting those BKB charges hurts, though. I mean, he needs to get an AC, and then he needs to get a lifesteal item. He needs something to go persist through these fights.
And Roche. So Power Ranger's like, well, thanks for starting it for us. We'll just take this.
And the issue here is once Shocklo commits to the pit, like, how can they actually kill him?
There's no real reason for them to fight into Exorcism. And now this game,
I'm not even
well
sure that's that big of a... I mean, that's annoying, but how important is an Aegis on Jakiro, really? It's
just another hero to
kill,
that's the problem, you know? Mm-hmm. They're having a tough time as it is killing a lot of these heroes, and they just need to find a way to be able to bring everybody down. I've got to say, Power Rangers have fought exceptionally well when it comes to making sure Pycat is getting kited, forcing out buybacks, making sure Sing Sing is really not involved, or just dying as quickly as possible. I mean, yes, he's going to have a Scotty very soon, but...
The thing is, this thing is just split-pushing like crazy this whole game.
Yeah. That's going to be how he gets his farm.
It's working extremely well. It's going to be a Scotty. Assume next. This could be a Hex, and I wouldn't hate it.
No, that would be fine, too, as long as they get Shocklo. Oh, it's an Assault Dross.
Boy.
Then, yeah.
I mean, he got 3,000 gold in that one big fight, so he turns that into an AC. That's a smart item choice, because he knows that, you know, AC, I talk about this sometimes, it's sort of like the arms race of Dota, you know, one team gets one, you're basically forced into getting one.
Yes.
Because if not, you're just at a huge disadvantage, especially when you've got something like Exorcism on your team. So, it's a really smart item choice for DP. Also, upping his armor, of course, personally, is extremely important.
This game has not felt like it's 30 minutes, it's felt a lot longer than that, and I have to say, Power Rangers are... One good fight away from taking it, probably. Buyback status, there's only one, and that's Sing Sing on Team Tinker, and he has a lot of gold, which he's probably going to spend pretty soon to get his Scotty, so...
Yeah. I mean, the pluses and minus here, if it's a Scotty, then his Meepos are obviously tanky. But Hex definitely seems like a thing he might be interested in. Hexing Shocklo seems pretty good.
That's it. I mean,
because you have the Blink Dagger, then you can Hex him, and you can just kill him.
Well, he can buy both outright, I think. Now, actually, maybe not the Scotty, but the Hex he can buy outright.
Well, the other thing is, does he want to hold on to buyback?
Yeah, buyback.
So.
That's exactly right.
Base is getting pressured. Exorcism's up in 1 second. Shocklo, is he going to use it? I think they'd rather hold it if they can.
Yeah, TP coming in, they glyph up the melee racks, and they don't want this going down and try to bring the illusion over. Riptide, like, go. Exorcism's going to fly. Here we go. Shocklo gets Stormhammered. And this is going to be a tough fight, I think, for Team Tinker. This Rax is looking like it's going to fall. Mech's going to go as well. They have Cheshire Cat on the backside. They might just let this Rax go.
Sing Sing is going bottom lane, though.
Yeah, he's going to look for that tier 3 bottom. They're going to take the Rax down. And if they can stop any sort of TPs towards that bottom lane, they might be able to take a Rax. But no.
Yeah, they're relying on Koikova for that.
I mean, they're going to back as a team. And they're going to TP away and not get caught out. And there's nothing that Team Tinker can do about this, unfortunately. So they lose the set of racks for nothing.
I think Sing Sing just misclicked.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, he's dead. I think he just misclicked. He, like, poofed alt, but he kept them all in place. I think he misclicked or something. I don't know. I can't imagine that was on purpose.
Weezysick is actually pretty speedy. He actually used the song to get out of that situation. And he's moving right towards Cheshire Cat. Chrono! Oh no, that's going to be on 4. They're looking for EGM. He's rather tanky, though. There's
really
the Crimson Guard. Mech has to back away. Mech is up. They're going to try to fight this Cheshire Cat. Has no time walk. That actually doesn't take any damage. There's the Waiting Rift. Gets blown up, actually. Shocklo coming in. No Exorcism. I don't know if this is the best fight for them, but for Team Taker, same could be said. Pie Kick inside his path. He has his BKB, and he's going to pop, and he's going to try to fight. Stormhammer only on to 1. Shocklo is very tanky. Yule Scepter up. Nexus now still here. Koifa behind the tree. Not where he wants to be. He can't get out. How unfortunate. The puck player, but they're still running him up. Blink. Waiting Rift. Shocklo. Very, very tanky, but is he tanky enough? The Fire Blast might go. They get the kill. Finally, he's down for 70 seconds. He will buy back. Macro Fire. Ice Path. Bulba. gets caught out. He's going to fall. Piecat trying to TP away and will make it just barely. Just,
wow, that he just barely makes it out of there. And Shocklo dies again, but he's up to 14-3, has bought back. Exorcism is going to be off cooldown in 25 seconds, so maybe they can push in. This game is really wild, and there's a lot of damage coming out of Piecat. And his BKB, though, is ticking down. It's now down to 5 seconds. The good news is that he can use that extremely liberally now. The bad news is, of course, it's much shorter. Sing Sing, 4,000 gold. We'll know his item choice very soon. I think either item is fine, but I like the Hex just to give him a better game against Shocklo actually killing him, because he's like all their damage at this point, you know?
We're going to find out. Sing Sing's heading bottom for whatever reason. They're not really trying to fight this.
Tier 3 tower doesn't really matter.
The Raxes matter, though. That range Rax is about to fall. And I don't know if you can come back from two sets of Rax down here in this game. They've got to fight soon. EGM thinking about jumping in with Piecat. BKB should be up, and in fact is. Stormhammer going in. There's the God Strength. Now the song going through. Can they burst Nexus down before the BKB is done? Yes, they can. But that's just an Aegis. What does that matter? There's the Chrono onto Piecat. Cheshire Cat coming in. We just think as well. The mech keeping that up and alive. Now the poop's coming in. Look at the damage from Sing Sing. They blow him up, but they're not dead yet. We just think is about to fall. Dream Coil onto two. Shocklo, no buyback, by the way. Fire Blasted. Multicast two times. Can they get this? The Tether Slow not there. Yule Scepter Sing Sing. He's going to have to poop in. He can throw up. There's Nets. He misses so all of them. Fast. No, Shocklo might get out. But there's the Tether. Multicast three times. Stuns up. Four dead. They lose the range Rax. Oh, the melee Rax is getting hit up by a siege creep, but that should be fine. They're going to push straight down mid now.
Huge fight for Tinker, though. Look what happens when Sing Sing really commits in these fights. He just tears everyone apart in combination with Piecat.
Did he buy his item yet? He's got 5,000. There it is. It is the Hex. He called it, buddy.
All right. Well, I mean, that feels right, because the biggest issue was they're sitting at the Raxes here. And Shocklo is just standing down here, and they have nothing they can do. There's no blink for Sven, so he can't blink forward and stun. So now they have Meepo, who can actually initiate these fights, so they can take them on their own terms, instead of having to wait until, like, the very end of Exorcism. And Koikva is leveling up to Stegen now, so...
Yeah, this is actually...
This is one hell of an item build. Blink into Midas into Stegen, what the fuck?
Piecat pops his God Strength. They might just get this Tier 3 tower. They already glyphed. No Death Prophet.
No Shocklo. What are they going to do?
I don't know. They might lose Rax here. This Rax is gone. It's obliterated. Song of the Siren not available either for another couple of seconds.
They're
going
to go for another Tier 3. Team Tinker are trying to just take this game now while Shocklo is dead, punishing him for the earlier buyback. They're going to get a full set of Rax here.
They're going to get two full sets of Rax, maybe. Nexus using the Shiva's Guard. He's up in the air with the Yule Scepter. Cheshire Cat comes in, but he gets Fire Blasted Dagon as well. They want Sing Sing, and that might get him. He will have buyback, though, but he's only down for 66 seconds. They bring down Cheshire Cat. What do they get done? Freezing Field pushing them back. Bulba caught out of position. They won't go for this fight. Bulba will get ensnared, will fall to Weegisick. Illusory Orb coming in as well. And they do not take a full set of Rax, but two melees.
They're now very sad that they went for the range Rax first in bottom lane, because the melee Rax is still alive. Mid lane, they do get the melee Rax. But as soon as Shocklo's up, they just have to leave. They're completely forced to just abandon, because Shocklo still has so much damage. With Meepo down, they have no way to kill Shocklo, basically. So, especially, you know, they use God Strength on the tower.
They're going to go again. They really want to get Sing before he respawns.
I mean, they have to. They would love to force a buyback here.
I don't know if they're going to get one out, but you look at Team Tinker, they actually have Glyph up
and
available.
Seems like they have to do it.
This is it for Power Rangers. If they lose this engagement, Glyph's available, will they use it, is the question. Sing Sing up in 10 seconds, he really doesn't want to have to buy back.
And, how much do they really care about this Rax?
I'm not sure if it's that big of a deal for them right now. Yule Scepter up in the air, that'll be on Piecat. Another Yule Scepter, he can't run in.
Looks like they don't really care. I mean...
That's not that big of a deal. They're going to try to fight this, though. Here comes Quickfire on the backside, I believe. Looking to find anything. Exorcism still going. Blink away coming out from Regisic. And now Nexus looks like he's going to Ice Path. Piecat gets stunned up. Quickfire still coming in on the backside. Blink, Coil, maybe on one, on a two, on a three. They were trying to get the song off. They will do so. Piecat pops the BKB. Nexus only tried to TP up. And now looks like Nexus will make it away as the song still goes. Poop forward here. Sing Sing blinks forward, but there's an immediate blink reaction from Regisic. And they will all make it away. They will not leave any last man standing, but no exorcism now. I think for Team Tinker, you fight here.
Yeah, the problem is that now if Power Rangers lose the fight, game's over. Completely
Team
over.
Tinker have Sing Sing with a double damage rune. So there's something. They're trying to do the Inagal Siren Illusion split push. it's not really being that effective. There's no Roshan for 5 seconds, less than that even.
50 seconds down. For buyback to come back off up for Death Prophet. And that's a big
move. Here we go, Jacklow. They get caught out. Now they're going to keep going. Cheshire Cat pops the big Chronosphere. Sigsaint getting blown up by the freezing field. He will fall. He's got to buy back to see if bots. Absolutely not. He's got to run towards the base. Nexus now getting multicasted as well. Buyback status, 30 seconds for Shockflow. He might have Exorcism when he respawns as well. They actually are just going to have to back away. Big Chronosphere. And they actually get it done. Freezing field nicely chopped down, so.
Yeah, there's the risk of the Hex, though, because it forces you to commit all of your heroes forward, but Sing's charging down middle with one Meepo. The rest are going to be in right behind him. Pycat trying to finish off the last Rangerax in the mid lane. Man, Bulba's had a rough game.
He's about to fall again. Dual Breath, Liquid Fire, he's done. Buyback status, so he has.
Oh, here we go. They're going to try to take down Melee Rax. There's a lot of buybacks for Tinker, not a lot for power. Well, they have Shocklow. That's probably the most important one. But without Exorcism, what does Shocklow do now?
They need it back now.
They're going to try to reinitiate.
Sing Sing just bought back, pooping away. Can't get out. Overcharge keeps him alive, but not for long. He will fall down for 86 seconds. There's the Stormbolt. They kill Nexus. Pycat's got a man up. I don't know if this is the right choice. He's got to back away. Cheshire Cat coming in. No Chronosphere. Weegisit comes in as well. The Crimson Guard. This could be it. They relocate Pycat out. EGM says, no, you're not dying. We're getting you out of here alive. EGM will fall, but
do they bring him back is the question.
I don't think so. Quick was not there. EGM's just gonna go ahead and just say, I'm a martyr, that's fine. Gets blown up, Mask of Madness pops, he falls immediately.
I wonder if he takes his hands off the keyboard and like kicks up his feet on the desk when that happens.
Jesus, take the wheel.
It's like, I'm dead. See you later, guys.
So, two sets of racks taken on both sides. This game has become a lot more close than I think many would have anticipated, given the start that Power Rangers had. But, Aegis and Cheese coming out now, man. This might be it. This could be a huge
Jesus, dude. Look at this gold graph. This is the definition of... Or, I guess XP is really indicative, but... The XP graph is just the definition of 6.82 things.
It's just a mountain followed by a valley. And then they're climbing another mountain.
Power Rangers are going to go for Osher, but Shocklow does not have Exorcism. J4 eats a stun. Pycat running forward. Koikva trying to blow up J4, and another great song by Weegisick.
Yeah,
I have to say, Naga and Jakiro have been amazing this game.
Shocklow
Jakiro especially has been amazing.
Yeah, I think Shocklow needs a refresh orb in this game.
Yeah,
they're going to rotate back around, and Bulba sees this coming.
Look, it's just dead. Roshan's dead.
They just take Roshan right now. Fireblast coming in on Cheshire Cat. He's got no... He does have a Chronosphere, but they're not jumping in. Pick up the Aegis Pycat. All right, you got it. There you go. Coil, they blow up Cheshire Cat with the Dagon from Koikva and the Dream Coil as well. J4 TP's away.
That's a Dagon.
Somehow they steal Rosh from underneath Power Rangers' noses. I don't understand how that happens, but... Amazing.
I mean, they can kill us so fast. Tons of minus armor, and he's just nice.
I think this is Tinker's game to lose now.
Yeah, it seems like it. I mean, it's a little awkward for them, but they have the invaluable Meepo tool, which is just enormous for keeping these lanes pushed out because they don't have. They're not even like committing a hero to defense, you know. They have Sing Sing, who's with one Meepo in the mid lane, but then he's got four Meepos up here. And the main Meepo is with them, so they have the Hex still.
Pycat
moving forward. And he has the Aegis, so he's just going to be manning up, I think.
Yule Scepter, Bulba pushing them all back. And there's going to be the Exorcism. Pycat doesn't really give a damn. He's like, I've got the Aegis. I don't care what you guys do. But they will finally back away. Koikva blinks out. BKB, Pycat manning up on Nexus. Song of the Siren going yet again, and Pycat... Well, he's going to get disabled by an Ice Tap going. Shocklow blowing them up. Freezing Field as well. Again, gets them some beautiful kills. EGM falls. No buyback. Pie gets up. He's backing away. They need to wait for Exorcism to be done. Nexus getting blown up, forced away. Yule Scepter up in the air. Pycat's still alive somehow. Exorcism is about to end, and it will. No refresh orb. Pycat, though, is going to fall. Double kill for Cheshire Cat. They get three done. Sing Sing just looks like he's going to poof away and makes it out in time.
Oh, there's no problem. He's fine.
And they will use the Earthbind to get him away. Sing Sing throws yet another one. Blink is going to be up in the second. He will blink away. And
this is still a little sketchy. He needs to run.
He's not blinking. He's not poofing.
Oh, boy.
Was that his Beeple Prime that got caught? No. Oh, he's actually just dead.
Wow.
Big turnaround. And with an Aegis and Cheese, they cannot get it done. They can't push him to the base. And I think they use the Cheese as well. No, it's still an Isle.
Still.
Exorcism, man, is just blowing up Team Tinker. There's nothing they can do about that ability. They can't kill Shockwave fast enough to bring him down. And now Sinks him down for 50 seconds. Buyback status, he doesn't have it. It's down for another minute and 22. Nice. Pycat will purchase his buyback, get back into the game. Quickfill has one, I believe. No. Not for 60 seconds. He's down still for that amount of time. And this Naga illusions are starting to do work. Multicast going on Shacklo, no exorcism for 40 seconds, and Pycat gets silenced up. Mule Scepter's Song of the Siren going again. BKB is available. Cronus turn up in 5 seconds for Cheshire Cat. Ice Path and Bulba, there's the macro. They're all stacking up, but no, they don't get the huge stun they were looking for. Pycat BKBs, Crimson Guard, making sure that they don't get much done, and the ensnare.
Oh, God.
Now you've got to maybe back away. Dagon, Cheshire Cat, Dream Coil. They want this kill. He breaks the stun with his time walk.
And backtracks the freaking snap. All right.
That's actually cool. Get a kill on Bulba, gets caught out. I'm lagging. Uh-oh. Why are we lagging?
Oh boy.
Damn it. This game was amazing. What happened? Bulba. I think we're about to get connected. We might have to load from save. Is this us?
I don't think so.
You're having some issues, guys. I don't know what's going on. I don't know what's happening. It looks like we were lagging. Yeah, mass lag coming. No one's kidding, luckily, but.
Are you seeing the game moving again?
It's paused currently.
So, there we go.
What a game. 42 minutes in. This is what we're looking for in the pick season 2. And the Power Rangers, they're trying to avoid going down 2-0 in this series, a two-game series, in fact. They want to trade this and get 1-1. Getting some connection issues here.
Yeah, we're gonna be settling. We have to wait for, honestly, like, a while, because we have to make sure this doesn't happen again in a fight. So we're just going to probably wait a little bit for everything to sort of settle here. Like, when you type, you have to make sure it's good to go. All right. Seems like we're ready.
Okay.
All right, we're not ready.
Bulba just disconnects and... just making sure things really fine.
You have to make sure when something like that happens that everything is actually okay. So.
AFK apparently on Power Ranger side. What a time to pause the game. And Sing's up actually in 2 seconds. Bulba bought back. So this is going to be maybe the fight of fights to end all fights. But
the problem here is that Shaklu has buyback and exorcism in 15 seconds.
Yeah,
so
he's good to go.
The exorcism is the big deal. I mean, buyback without exorcism at this point is pretty useless. The thing is that Pycat is starting to become pretty resilient to the exorcism. So it's sort of an issue. I mean, the thing is that exorcism still just shreds a lot of the other heroes.
It does. I mean, like, and it's not even just the exorcism, it's the exorcism, chronosphere, and
the biggest problem is that they initiate on Shocklo and then they get chronoed.
The freezing field is actually doing a ton of damage to a lot of these heroes, including even Pycat. I mean, the magic damage actually is just ridiculous. We kind of questioned the crystal main poor choice, but
it's still working out. I mean, they've had passive lanes that they were looking for. Just let Crystal Main do her thing, and that's when she really shines, so.
Yeah, I mean, this is James low in half health. I'm just trying to think of what this is. There's this being cast, you can land, and you can't really, now that will matter. The Ensnare's gonna keep him standing near, and I think at this point in time, once this exorcism is back up, if they can type high at a long time, long enough for that exorcism to be up, they probably win this fight. Although there are some creeps entering the base looking for some tier 4 towers, however, I don't think that's that big of an issue. They won't take the base by the time this fight's over, so this is gonna be quite the unpause coming out.
Yeah, the suspense is building. The tension is building, guys.
I don't know if you can build much more, but...
But the biggest problem here is that no one on Tinker has buybacks, so they need to be very careful if they decide to push into the base right now, because with Exorcism coming off cooldown, if they lose the fight, they could just lose. But, I mean, I don't know if I can see them losing a fight without Exorcism getting used. So,
Maybe
it's not that big of a risk. I don't know. When it's past 40 minutes, you don't have buyback, fighting is extremely risky.
Yeah, especially I mean, Team Ticker lose this fight, they lose the game. That's just it. That's it. That's gonna be it. There's no buyback on any of their heroes. There's nothing they can really do at this point in time. So, Team Tinker in a rough position now. Guys, I want to thank you all for joining us. This is the last game of the Dota Pit League Season 2 for today. We'll be back, not tomorrow, but the day afterwards. Again, my name is Mont. With me is What Is Hip. And we're jumping back into the game. Here we go. Pycat, he's going to get ensnared right on the bat, but they will just blink away. They're not going to fight this. And relocate. Oh. They're going to go to the base. They want to man up. They want to try to take this Pycat. The tier 4 tower is done. Look at this measured play coming out. They might even just take the entire base. Glyph is not available. The TP's coming back in the well. They relocate back just in time. No, the Yule Scepter, not enough.
Yeah, they keep back Faceless Void as well, but there's enough heroes coming back. Now the throne is exposed, though, and this now becomes a super dicey game for Power Rangers with, you know, you can relocate in Sing Sing, you can relocate in Pycat. Either of those are a huge threat to your base. If one of them gets BOTs and there's creeps in your base, then you've got serious issues. Having that throne exposed is huge, and, you know, sometimes you have these really long pauses and there's, you know, that was no one's fault. It's just server lag, and I think Team Tinker... Little masterstroke of brilliance there, taking out those tier 4s.
Yeah. Perfectly done. They take the tier 4s down. Now your Ancient is exposed. And any play that you make if your Power Rangers now has to be extraordinarily calculated. Otherwise, there's a chance you get ratted. You have to have a Glyph as well. That's the tough thing, is that next time you try to do this for Team Tinker, there's going to be a Glyph available. And we won't even know when Roshan's up because of the lag. All we see is the nice little magic wand and Quelling Blade sitting there in the pit. Sing Sing now with still his Aghanim's Sight Device, his Blink Dagger, buyback status is up. Usually only one in Tinker that has it. And a very important hero to have it on. Pycat has the cheese, 2300 in gold. And I don't know what you do. I don't know who really comes out on top. You have to get buyback if you're Pycat here, and he actually has enough money, just not time. Still down for 3 minutes. Crystal Nova, Pycat doesn't want to have to BKB here. They're still chasing him down. Yule Scepter, this is a problem.
They might have to commit to this fight.
They're going to relocate him out. Nice. Oh, no. Beautifully done. They don't even have to waste the BKB. And now everyone's rotating over here from Team Tinker. They might even
are they going to go back in on this?
I think they are. And they're going to relocate in. Bulb is sitting on the backside. Shocklo has his Exorcism. They relocate back in. But they're gonna just back away.
They need Meepo. Sing Sing's coming over.
Siren. Quakefla avoiding most of it. Meanwhile, they're gonna catch out EGM Bulba. Pycat, Macro Pyre, Freezing Field gonna go. BKB on J4, so he can't get the entire one off. He's gonna fall first. Big cleave, but Nexus gets the double kill coming up. Pycat getting low from the Exorcism. Meepo on the backside. Sing Sing trying to do work. Crimson Guard, there's the Hex up. Can they get the kill on Shocklo? Sing Sing solo, he is gonna fall. Triple kill for Nexus. And they will bring down Pycat, it looks like. He's up in the air with the Yule Scepter. Now he pops the cheese. The Exorcism still doing work. Cheshire Cat, no Chronosphere available. Pycat about to fall, and will. They finally take a fight.
The throne, though, is taking some damage now, so they can't push.
Yeah, this is the thing.
The biggest
can just take these fights now from now on.
The biggest issue, though, is that I didn't even consider this. Crimson Guard is incredibly good against Meepo.
It's incredibly good against a lot of the heroes.
Like,
against Pycat.
Yeah, I mean, it's okay against Pycat, but Pycat has enough damage where it's not that bad. But against Meepo, it, like, almost halves his damage. Like, when Shocklo was getting right-click there before Crimson Guard, he definitely dies. After, he's, like, complete... He's fine. Like, he did not take much damage at all. He also has 6,000 gold. Jesus.
Yeah, Shocklo is...
This game is insane.
Time. It's refresher time for Shocklo. That's exactly what he needs to buy, and I think he will. Yep, there it is. Perseverance coming out. So now the refresh orb about to be completed. 45 minutes in, we might have a victor in the next couple of minutes or so. Meepo's going to respawn up. Pycat has no buyback for minute 43. He's up in 30. So now you've got to defend your last set of racks.
Without Exorcism, though, I think they're okay.
I think it's going to... He hasn't actually bought it yet. He could fly it out now if he wanted to. He's plenty of money
by then, I think Sven will be up. So they shouldn't be in too much trouble here. Tier 3 doesn't matter. They just need to make sure they don't get mega.
They have Glyph, and I don't think you use it now. You have to wait for Exorcism.
No, you have to wait, yeah.
Sing Sing continues to farm top. He's got 2,500 gold. He's been sitting there for some time. Sing is just getting blown up in a lot of these fights. He actually just can't live long enough for him to do enough damage.
Yeah, he needs a heart now. I mean, this is the downside. The other downside of Hex is he's missing a lot of HP that he would have gotten from Scotty.
Exactly,
so.
Yeah.
I mean, I think it's still a really good item choice. It's worked out for them a little bit. The biggest issue is they have Chrono as well. So when Sing blinks forward and hexes him, he gets Chronoed. So they need to figure out a way to deal with Cheshire Cat.
Power Rangers just need to take just solid fights. And they have the ability to do so. For Team Tinker, it's very difficult for them to come out on top in these fights because of how much they're getting kited and how much Thing is getting blown up.
Yeah, Pycat's definitely getting kited. And maybe this feels like it could have been an Ags game for Koikafa, just to ensure that they always get the snaps. Yeah. I mean, there's no... I don't think there's a single B-Kib yet for PR, so maybe not, but...
I don't believe they have one. Nexus does, actually. He just purchased it, I believe.
All right, well...
J4 is building an Axe. He might build... You should, I think about building towards a BKB instead for Crystal Maiden, just because she gets, like, maybe a second or two off.
She's had some uninterrupted ulties, though.
Yeah, like, but the last fight was a pretty good example of her getting stunned up and brought low. Mm-hmm. Roshan's up in 20 seconds, by the way. This is getting to be critical mass. The smoke, which we haven't seen all game from Team Tinker, they're looking for bottom. Nexus is actually going to just TP away, and so will we just second. Is there? Oh my god, it connects the long duration TP. Nexus, I think he doesn't have buyback. He just used it. He's about to fall. BKB's going to go. No TP. Yule Scepter up in the air. Meanwhile, top lane, Song of the Siren is going to go. Nexus will fall. Looks like not yet anyways, he's about to go down. BKB, EGM getting popped up with the Chronosphere. Pycat getting right-clicked down, he's not taking any damage, but this is going to be tough for him. He will have buyback. Cheshire Cat getting blown up, but...
This is awful. Look at him just standing here.
He can't do anything.
He must be so frustrated. He really needs lifesteal. He needs a lifesteal item and he needs a crit.
Well, he goes down, he's down for 77 seconds. Again, he has buyback. No exorcism used there, by the way, so not even one refreshed. And now the Aghanim is done for Cheshire Cat. I just don't know if there's any real way Team Tinker can take
I think there's... because the Thorona is exposed, I think you can never count them out. Because there's a Wisp, and it's EGM. Like, EGM is definitely one player that I would want on my side if there was an exposed Thorona and you were a little bit down.
Yeah, I mean, he knows how to do this. That's true.
This XP graph is seriously one of the most ridiculous things I've ever seen.
I can't even... begin to fathom how that actually, well, it's just ridiculous.
I mean, they changed all the gold bounties, but XP bounties are still fairly absurd. But
I mean, is everyone level 25 yet? No, not even close.
Yeah.
EGM's still level 15. That's actually surprising. He's been getting blown up so often in these fights. But now that there's a refresher, this is so real tough for Team Tinker to take a fight.
Basically, now it's almost completely a positional battle, but the refresher orb does make it a lot easier for Power Rangers to win because normally the issue is you use the exorcism to win the fight, so you can't kill the base. But the refresher, you can use for both.
Yes.
The biggest issue, though, is there's a Wisp, there's a Sven, there's a Meepo. There's a lot of heroes that are really good at killing buildings and have a lot of damage. And there's an exposed throne, so... Behold! At this point, I think it's anyone's game, but I don't think Team Tinker will lose until they all use buyback. Well, right now, only one of them have it, though, so that's a little scary.
Pycat have it now. They must have just gotten it for Sing or something, I don't know. He's had a lot of money. There's still a tier 2 tower top that Sing Sing and Team Tinker desperately want to take. They can't take Megas, not that they... I guess if you get Megas, this
Megas are pretty good for... Megas are pretty good for Team Tinker. For Power Rangers, it's not that big of a deal. Oh, Smoke, they're going to try to make a fight here.
Shockwave getting hexed up now. There's going to be the Stormhammer. There might be a Naga Song coming in. They blow up Shockwave. No! He heals his up and he's still alive. One right click from Pycat. They can't kill him. No. They cannot kill him. Pycat can't get it done. He survives on very low HP, but now with no Song up, will they survive? Shockwave trying to get out of there. They will have to try to TP away. And it looks like Shockwave gets out. Dagon not there. Not going to stop him from TPing. Unbelievable. You've got to be so frustrated for Team Tinker with that last engagement. Oh my god, the Yule Scepter.
I mean, they wouldn't have won from that fight, but forcing a buyback at this point is so valuable. That was ridiculous how close he was to dying. Oh my god, that Yule Scepter. And Pycat also, his BKB ended at the worst time possible, right at the end there. Oh, that is unbelievably frustrating for Team Tinker.
This is where the BKB change is probably the most infuriating thing in the world for Pycat.
Yeah, I mean, he would love a new BKB right now. He would happily pay 10,000 gold for a new BKB.
Koikfu getting used up. He can't blink. He can't even phase shift. And Bulma's going to be along with him. And Koikfu should fall here. And will. And no buyback for Koikfu. What a misplay for him being out of position. And now this might be Power Rangers time
bad,
to go. They have
a now the exorcism is up. Because of the refresher.
I don't know if you defend this now. Koikfa's been putting in so much work. This might be the end here. Shaco's going to wait for his first exorcism to end. They'll take Mega Creeps, pop the second exorcism, and go to town. The Raxes are even going to fall on the first exorcism. No, they pop the glyph, and Shaco has to refresh and And they're going to chase him down, but I don't. They haven't used it yet. Meanwhile, there's the refresher. They're going to fight again. Exorcism, Song of the Siren. I'm not sure. Song is going to go. Buyback coming in. That'll be from Peshire Cat, who got caught out and killed by Meepo. And now Pycat backs away. They're going to bloodlust on a couple of heroes. And that actually, that refresher does nothing for them. They pop the exorcism at maybe the wrong time. And Team Tinker lived to fight another day, it looks like.
Yeah, that was...
That was questionable.
Yeah, that was very... That was... I think Team Tinker, big sigh of relief for them when they see that second exorcism use.
Yeah.
Their base, obviously, is still okay, so... Man, this game is... Now we're at 52 minutes, and when games go this late, things happen, and... I mean, occasionally, you just randomly lose when you probably shouldn't, especially when your throne is exposed, so... Power Rangers... I mean, with this refresher in pretty good position, but with it being used there for nothing, that's 2 minutes with no double ulti and 80 seconds until there's no exorcism at all. So maybe Team Tinker just push right now. I think they're going to. They have a lot. They have a couple buybacks.
Not anyone. I don't
know.
I mean,
they have Pycat and Meepo. That seems like the most important
one. This
ones.
Is dangerous for them, but I like the decision making here. They're going to try to take one fight.
But can they actually lose the fight with no exorcism? I don't think so. We'll find out.
It's going to be tough. It's going to be tough for Nexus to fight this. And this is going to be, I think, Team Tinker's time. Pycat still songed up. Weezysec, now that's over. Macropyre and again, the Instair flying through. Pycat getting brought low.
He has
God
now.
Strength. BKB for Nexus now. And this is going to be it. They're going to go right to the Ancient, right to the base here.
Oh, he whipped the Chrono. There's
nobody
in there.
There's nobody there. And now, Pycat, you've got to hit the base, I think. But here we go. Sing Sing poofs up. There's the Hex on Shacklow. Can they bring him down? Absolutely. He's got to buy back now, and he probably will. The Cleave, Pycat, BKB's. One hit, two hit, double kill. Pycat is pumping you up. They're going to take the base, but there's going to be the Glyph coming out. Now the Freezing Field. Pycat cannot afford to die. The Stormhammer comes in just in time. There's the Overcharge coming through. They take it. They take the Ancient. They turn it around. 55 minutes into the game, and Team Tinker take one of the best games I've seen in some time. Power Rangers extraordinarily well played, but they go down in this great series.
Power Rangers played so well right up until that refresher actually just lost them, like, the game. When they refreshed, did nothing with it, because with the refresher,